In addition to looking at wildlife and other Earth-based objects, you can also point a spotting scope towards the sky and capture the moon, sun, planets, and even the Orion Nebula. The moon is the easiest of these to capture, but you will need a steady tripod and some way to activate the camera shutter remotely, such as a Bluetooth shutter remote. Set the scope to the smallest zoom factor. Getting the scope centered on the moon can be a bit tricky. You can use the sight bead on the lens hood if your scope has one. Otherwise, you will have to look down the length of the scope from the rear in order to get it on target. It's also best to look into the eyepiece yourself when fine-tuning the position. Once you have the moon in view, get it focused and attach the phone to the eyepiece. Make sure the mount is seated evenly, or you might notice part of the moon is out of focus. I mentioned in an earlier video about turning off the phone's vibrate function before shooting videos. That also applies to shooting sky objects, whether pictures or videos. If your phone has a pro or manual mode, I recommend using that over auto mode. This will give you full control over the camera settings. Also, the software might save raw image files in addition to JPEG, which gives more flexibility if the images need to be edited later. Keep in mind that the file size of the raw images will be much larger than JPEG. If you are having problems with dirt spots even after cleaning, there's tips later in this video to remove those with the smartphone and the scope focuser. In this phone's pro mode, the ISO can be changed. Shutter speed is the next button up. MF is manual focus, something very important for astrophotography. WB is the white balance. This changes the color temperature of the image. Set the ISO and shutter speed. On this full moon, I started out with an ISO of 100 and a shutter speed of 1/1000th of a second. Next is fine-tuning the focus. Slide your finger up and down the focus selector until you find a focused image. If the image still looks blurry, you will also need to turn the focuser on the scope and try again. Some camera software has focus peaking, which displays a colored outline around areas of high contrast. In this case, the focus peaking is the green circle around the moon. Use the digital zoom to get a closer look at the moon's edge and craters. Slowly adjust the phone's focus until the moon edge and craters look sharp. Don't zoom in with the scope's optical zoom for this part. You'll see later why that won't work. Even at 20x, the moon can be seen slowly rising. Fine-tune the rest of the settings, if necessary. These look good to me. I left the white balance on auto as it looked the same to the naked eye. This phone has two aperture settings, with f-stops of 1.5 and 2.4, found in the shutter speed menu. Setting the f-stop to 2.4 slightly closes the aperture and reduces the amount of light reaching the camera sensor. The white balance changed, but that can be fixed in post-processing. Lock in a setting if you wish. Now it's time to take a picture and see how it looks. This is where the shutter remote, delay timer, or voice activation comes in handy. Let's zoom in a little. This one looks good. Let's look at the moon at 30x. I mentioned earlier not to change the scope zoom factor when focusing, and now you can see why. The scope's focus is not locked to the zoom dial, so now we have to go through the focusing steps again. Now, the moon at 60x. Adjusting the focus actually becomes more difficult the more the scope is zoomed in. This is where a dual speed focuser would come in handy. At this zoom, the moon fills most of the scope's field of view, which also means you won't have much time to take pictures before the moon starts to move out of view. Also, while keeping the same settings from the 20x shots, the moon now looks dimmer, so the shutter speed or ISO will need to be adjusted to make it look brighter. With videos, you can watch the moon move across the frame or do a time lapse. I forgot to turn off video stabilization in the settings menu, so when switching from photo to video mode, the image enlarged on the screen and was cropped. As before, it doesn't take long before the moon starts to leave the field of view at 60x. a bit longer to view at 30x. At 20x, I'm positioning the moon along the lower left edge and seeing how long the moon takes to move across the frame, nearly 4 minutes. DSLR imaging. After putting the Canon 90D on the scope, the moon was much larger at 20x versus the phone. The introduction video has an explanation as to why this can happen. The moon looked darker using the same settings from the phone images. The ISO had to be increased to 1000. Here's the moon at 30x and at 60x. Those small black specks are dust or dirt spots somewhere in the spotting scope's optics. When using the phone to image, the phone's internal lens can be set to unfocus these spots, while still getting a sharp focus on the objective. That's not the case with the DSLR, which doesn't have a lens between the camera and the scope. The crescent moon. Looking at a crescent moon is a different experience than a full moon. I'm starting off with the regular photo mode, and you can see the unlit side of the moon. The surrounding sky was still dark blue as the sun had not completely set. The focus can be locked and the exposure adjusted, but the bright part is still overexposed. The same experience in video mode. Going into pro mode, the exposure is decent, so it's time to adjust the focus. I'm looking at the focus peak in green outline and the moon's craters. This time, I'll take a picture at a low ISO and at 1/500th of a second shutter. Now at ISO 800 and 1/1000th of a second. Slowing down the shutter speed brings out the unlit part of the moon. The crater details are easier to see now that the sun has almost set. There's also a night mode on this phone that is good for low light photography. It's another auto mode, so only the focus lock and exposure compensation can be used. I hope your moon photos turn out great. For tips about using a spotting scope on the sun, including solar eclipses, check out the video in the upper right corner. I'll see you there.